falls in construction continues to be one of the main focuses of not only OSHA fines and violations, but of just total worker safety when it comes to keeping these workers safe. I believe falls make up almost 40% of construction deaths, and Kentucky continues to see about that same rate when it comes to falls in construction. We have made modest gains in the past few years, but work is still needed to be done. Our FACE program is a NIOSH-funded grant in which we investigate any fatalities that happen to workers inside of Kentucky. We take a look at some of our occupational health indicators to determine if those need to be investigated. If we do decide to pick up one for investigation, we do an in-depth report. We make site visits, we make recommendations, corrective actions, we find any root causes. These are very in-depth reports in which we send to not only that company, but to companies of the like. We send them to our listservs. We try to get the information out there as much as possible so that we can prevent that type of injury and that type of death from happening again.
Here in Kentucky, we have been with the Stand Down for Falls campaign since they started. It's been 5 years. We send out letters of invitation for participation to 5 different unions. We go on TV and radio to help promote the campaign prior to the campaign. We publish it on our Twitter and our Facebook accounts and social media to encourage employers because it goes out to a lot of people. Another great tool that we have is we team up with Kentucky OSHA every year, and there's billboards across the state of Kentucky that's promoting the Stand Down and Falls for Construction. And we have on-site toolbox talks. Every year we are invited back.
So when we go and do our toolbox talks for these Stand Down campaigns, we bring the personal level into it. We let these people know, hey, somebody has lost their son, somebody has lost their husband, their father. And you can really see when somebody hears that in the construction industry, that's who they're working for. They're there working to provide for their families, for their wives, and for their children. So we want to make sure that any time that we take this message out to them, we connect with them on a personal level. We don't want to just be the big bad safety oversight that comes in and tells them what they're doing wrong. We're not interested in coming down with fines or violations. We're interested in total worker health, and we're interested in stopping these falls from happening because we believe that they're all preventable.
Talking to the workers every year, I think that it engages them because I don't lecture them, I don't give them statistics, I make it personal. I make it personal about their spouses, their children, their families, their lifestyle. And all of them love to get these stickers for their hard hats. And so they're willing to participate.
We do try to make all construction companies know that if you are going to hire a worker whose English is not their primary language, that you need to provide that safety training in their native language, whether that's Spanish or whether it's French. We do see a lot of immigrants into the area. They're known for being very hard workers. They want to get the job done at all costs, but they oftentimes do that at the risk of their own safety. So we want to make sure that these construction companies are taking the time to train these people properly, and even if that requires bringing in translated material or a translator in order to give their safety training. So we want to make sure that everybody who's going out and doing a job for you understands what they're doing and how to do it safely.
I think with the employees that we have been talking to, I think it makes them more active. They are more willing to tell a coworker, hey, you're working unsafe. This is what you need to do. We need to correct this behavior. And I think that they help with the new hires by guiding them and actually living it and showing them this is how it's done here.
So in the future, I want to make sure that not only do we get our message out to the bigger companies, but finding a way to communicate with those smaller companies. A lot of times it's hard to reach those companies, A, because we don't know that they exist, and B, that sometimes turnover happens so much inside of them that we're not really sure who they have or what kind of experience they have. So when we want to reach out to these smaller mom and pop companies, we want to make sure that we're visiting them, that hey, our emphasis is on you. These are your family members that are working for you. These are close personal friends that are working for you. So if somebody were to fall and have an accident, it could change not only their lives, but your lives as well.